We'll do everything we can, but I'm afraid we cannot guarantee a recovery. I'm sorry.
It's quite all right. I very much appreciate your diligence.
And you? Do you consider yourself prepared?
Yes. I shall do everything within my power that I can.
Your distinctive personality is a point I greatly admire as your teacher, but I am aware that it also tends to drive the chancellors up the wall. Don't push yourself too hard. I'll let you know if anything happens.
Yes. Oh, Saray!
Hello there. Should I come back later?
Not at all. I was just leaving.
Oh, you're...
I thank you for your help at the festival, Shepherd Saray. I am Maltran, Knight Preceptor and Advisor to the Royal Army of the Kingdom of Highland. Please do all you can to help Alicia. She could use the support of a good friend.
Yes, of course. Wow, I gotta say, she's totally got it together.
I know, right? My dream is to be as cool as her. Let's walk while we chat. You were investigating the ruins, correct?
Well, yes, that's true. This is for you.
My knife! Did you find this at the ruins near Alicia?
Yeah, I figured it was yours.
This is an important item that's been handed down in my family for generations. I thought I'd never see it again. Thank you so much.
I do apologize, but may we get down to the matter at hand?
Lady Lila, forgive me.
Wait! Did you just...
I could hear her. I definitely heard Lila's voice.
Well, this is quite the surprise. Hello? I see. So it won't be that easy just yet.
Lila?
I'll explain things, but first, take her hand again.
Lila says she'll explain. Can you give me your hand again?
Sure.
Hello, Alicia? Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, I can. Loud and clear.
I haven't even held my breath yet.
At this point, you've grown much more accustomed to my power, to the extent that you can now do what you did before without dulling your other senses.
I don't feel any different, though.
That's good news. It means you don't have to go through all that hassle anymore to make her voice carry.
It was fun in a way, but good riddance.
All right. Very well, then. Shall we begin?
All right. Lila needed to talk with you about something.
With me?
I would ask that you lend us your power, so that we may find the vessels and the lords of the land.
May I ask what those might be?
To explain fully, I shall need to tell you how this world we live in is structured. In the ancient times, the Seraphim and humans worked together in order to protect their land from the malevolence.
The Seraphim and humans worked together?
If the vessel they dwelled in was pure of heart and harbored no malevolence, those Seraphim with power would become lords of the land. And through worship by the people, they gain the ability to expand the area of the blessed domain, which repels the influence of the malevolence. The sanctuaries were built to honor the lords of the land and keep the area around the sanctuary safe from malevolence. However, the sanctuary in this town has neither a lord of the land nor a vessel, let alone anyone who will properly pray to them.
Is that why there's so much bad stuff going down around here?
Yes. Even if the Shepherd purifies the malevolence, it will be impossible to maintain the land's protection without the blessings of the Lord of the Land.
I see. So you wanted to ask Alicia for help in finding a suitable vessel for the Lord of the Land.
And should they be found, if those of the Sanctuary would properly worship them both, is that correct?
Precisely. Any ideas?
As for the Sanctuary, I'm afraid almost all of the pious ones in my country have lost their sense of gratitude towards the Seraphim.
No way!
However, there is a man named Brunor who has recently ascended to the priesthood. He is a good, sincere man who gave his time to help us prepare for the festival.
Would he help?
Yes, I believe so. Time is of the essence. I'll head for the sanctuary at once.
Well, that was abrupt.
But she's not wrong either. We must hurry.
She's gone already. She's probably heading over to the sanctuary.
She's quite the tomboy, that Alicia.
It looks like Father Brunor is out around town on an errand.
So it goes. Any clue as to the vessel, at least?
Let's see. Something free of malevolence. In the Galahad ruins north of here, there's a pure and clean waterfall. The kings of Highland traditionally bathe in its pristine holy water before their coronation ceremonies.
Water of utmost purity. That does sound like something that could be a vessel for a seraph.
Is something wrong?
Beasts have taken up residence in the ruins of late. Whatever was there was strong enough to kill all 10 soldiers who came to drive them out.
Hellions?
Likely.
If we don't hurry, then the waterfall could be corrupted by the malevolence. I take it that's not all, is it?
The malevolence is strong in LadyLake. The holy water will absorb its influence before we have a chance to enshrine and worship it. Water in particular is delicate and easily corrupted by malevolence.
No way! Is there anything we can do?
Of course there is. But in that case, we will need the cooperation of a seraph of water. As a fire seraph, I'm afraid I am wholly mismatched.
A water seraph, huh?
Yes.
By the way, whatever became of Mikleo? I haven't heard his voice yet.
We... sort of had a fight.
It's a long story.
Anyway, to the Galahad ruins! There's Hellions to smack.
That's true. Let's do what we can, first and foremost.
Saray, please let me accompany you.
I would, but you don't have the power to battle Hellions.
But...
Saray, just as the Prime Lord can have sublords, so too can there be squires to the Shepherd. If Alicia becomes your squire, she can fight against the Hellions as long as she is within your domain.
My squire?
But...
this sanctuary... no, make that all of the sanctuaries in Highland. They have always been like this from the time I was born. A Highland overrun with malevolence is the only Highland I've ever known. I beg of you, Saray, please! Take me as your squire, so that I may see my homeland free of malevolence.
Just like you'd always dreamed of. As you wish, Alicia. So then, how does this work?
After my incantation, give unto Alicia a true name in the ancient tongue.
Let's see, a true name for Alicia.
A new bud forms on the holy branch. Its flowers bring fruit. Its fruit begets seeds. The circle of destiny turns once more. Give life unto the will of the shepherd, and let it be proof of their bond. Thy true name as a squire shall be...
Melphis Amekia!
Happy to be your squire, Saray.
Happy to have one, Alicia.
It's nice to get a break.
Yes, but still.
Is something the matter?
Not really. I'm just amazed all over again that Seraphim really truly exist. Talking to you like this, it's like a dream come true.
Alicia grew up reading the Celestial Record like me. She always wanted to meet a Seraph.
I too am glad that we are able to talk like this.
And I suppose that means that Saray's family was actually there that whole time.
That whole time?
I was searching for the origin village in the past when I stumbled across Saray's hometown. He graciously introduced me to his family, but at the time, I thought he was just being peculiar. I fear I may have been rude.
I see. So you were looking for the origin village.
Don't worry about it. Everyone there is super nice.
That means a lot to me. Thank you. I hope I can meet Mikleo soon as well.
Yeah, me too.
So the world teems with these monsters called Hellions that cannot be seen by normal humans. And it is they who are the true scourge of the Age of Chaos.
Yes. The havoc you see in the weather and people's emotions alike all stem from the influence of the Hellions.
The Lord of Calamity creates malevolence in Hellions. And the Shepherd's role is to stop him from doing that.
As is that of the Squire, correct?
I already told Saray much the same, but this is something I want you to determine for yourself. What you want to do with the world, with the humans, with the malevolence. I'd like you to make your own decisions, based on your honest and forthright heart, rather than having them imposed on you by destiny.
But is it acceptable to express myself that openly? I'm merely a squire.
A squire is not a shepherd's subordinate, but one who provides help to him.
Yep. I'm gonna need all the help I can get.
Okay. Then if something is on my mind, count on me to say it.
How inspiring.
Inspiring? But, Alicia, you kinda, grazed me.
I'm so sorry. I was in the moment. What on earth?
Here it comes, Alicia!
Remain calm. Search. Just attack it like you would any other creature.
No escape! It's over! Yeah! Be gone! No escape! How's this?
Prepared is to be protected. I concur. Finished all the preparation. I am ready.
Ready? No escape! It's over! Burn of fire! Burn! Burn away! I'll strike you down! Alright! Break through!
Burn out! Spread out! Go! As you wish.
Move forward!
It's over!
Burning echo!
Never!
Burning star!
Where's your head?
Looks like we win! Is that a monolith?
Yes.
Hellion?
Sense the ancient tongue. We're near one. I just saw a monolith written in ancient tongue.
Very well. Come at me,
Strike! Guess we can't hit them by flailing our weapons.
Be gone!
Be gone, everyone!
Yeah!
Be gone! Strike! Yeah! Be gone! No escape! It's over! Not yet!
I must try
Let's get him! Not
Wait,
yet!
Please. I must clear
Yeah!
Wait,
Ready?
Please.
This is a Hellion.
You okay?
Sorry. I'm fine. I finished preparing the gel.
I don't think we've checked that monolith out yet.
Victory and sally forth. My will shall pierce thee, just like this spear.
A bow. It looks like it's just ceremonial.
This bow is a divine artifact.
A what? Oh, right. Hold on. So if this bow is a divine artifact, what does that mean?
A divine artifact determines the form the Armatus will take. Essentially, it serves as a model for the Armatus.
A model for the Armatus?
Oh, yeah. Like Lila's sacred blade.
The sacred blade of LadyLake is also a divine artifact.
Huh. And that's why your Armatus is a sword. Hey! Does this mean that I can use your sacred blade to armatize with other seraphim as well?
Well, that depends on the circumstances. First, as I mentioned earlier, just as I am the Prime Lord of you, the Shepherd, they would have to become my sublord in turn.
What exactly is a sublord?
Put simply, it is the title for one who assists Saray while working under the influence of my power. Consider the elemental property of the divine artifact. Each seraph has their own unique element that falls under their control. Mine, for instance, is fire.
So if the divine artifacts all have their own elements, does that mean a seraph can't armatize with it if their element is different?
Indeed it does. It would appear this bow's element is water. And Mikleo is a water seraph.
Let's go!
Huh?
Saray does not wish to make Mikleo his sublord.
Why not? It's no different than when I was made a squire.
But you called on the Shepherd's power in order to achieve your dream. Isn't that right? Mikleo is different. That?
Saray, there's something written on the arrow pedestal. It looks like ancient tongue.
Oh, show me! Don't walk off with relics and other junk you find in the ruins, okay? And no breaking stuff. On the other hand, treasure chests are fair game. So go nuts.
Very lighthearted, these ancients.
I'm not so sure. The distinction between academic research and crass looting can be very fine indeed. Perhaps their buried message is contemplate always the true intent of your actions?
Now you're taking it too far in the other direction.
Nothing wrong with interpreting it that way. But I'm thinking this might just be a joke the ancients left for us.
Indeed. Ruins are made by people just like us, so it only makes sense for them to reflect human nature. Quite profound.
That's what we like about you, Alicia. You're, sincerity.
Is that a monolith? Thank you.
opponent,
Hellion! Radiant Heat! Fire!
Agitus Hellions are well enough! Do not underestimate what humans can do. Was wide open.
Really? I need more practice. Careful.
Yes. What? Where?
Above!
I can see it. Don't. It's poisonous.
Stop! Lila, get back!
Okay.
Fatma's Mioma! Vermilion Crescent! Burning Star! Powers of Pain! Move forth!
Burning Echo!
Burn away!
Victoria
Flame! I'll strike you down! Let's get him! Burn away! Powers! Oh no! The Armatus' attacks aren't working on them!
They're resistant to fire! My powers know you. There's still so many of them!
Dang! Twin World! Mikleo! You couldn't have timed that better.
Lila, let me become your sub-lord.
Are you sure about this?
Wait, hold on now!
You're right. I am stubborn as a rock.
Huh?
I admit it. I'm hell-bent on becoming a sub-lord. But there's something important that you don't understand.
I do understand. I just didn't want you to get involved.
Get over yourself. Do you really think this is your dream alone?
Says.
You can hear him too?
This is our dream.
Now, Lila!
Very well. O ye born of the sacred currents of peace,
Mikleo! Milo!
Here let our path be forged, that my unquavering incandescence may be as thy purification. Shouldst thou accept this burden, recite aloud your etc.
etc.?
Now for the Armatus. Mikleo, give Saray your true name!
He already knows.
You bet I do!
Oh my!
Here we go, Mikleo!
Let's end this. We can't afford to hold back.
Let's now my chance!
Oh, you did right!
This is our Armatus!
I'll do the aiming, Saray.
All right. I'm counting on you.
Open the flood gate!
Bubble arrow!
Blue flurry!
Breakdown! Open the flood gates! Bubble arrow! Burst! Ocean split! Breakdown! Azure Assault!
Wow, that was amazing, you two! Oh, were you able to remove it?
Now that you mention it, it just came off.
I wonder why.
Does it really matter? Besides, this means that I can now use the Armatus at will, right?
Lost those training wheels. Look at you.
Shut up.
Makes sense. So, that's why you couldn't take it off before.
Mikleo, I wanted to say...
Don't thank me. After all, I merely did this for my own dream.
I know that.
I feel oddly envious.
Agreed.
Alicia, don't tell me!
Yes. Not only can I hear your voice, I can see you now.
No way! You can see Seraphim now?
I think it just goes to show how strong you've already gotten.
Maybe we do have a fighting chance against this Lord of Calamity.
Saray.
Lila. Mikleo. Please accept my sincerest gratitude for saving me.
It was nothing, I assure you. But you're welcome.
I thought we weren't supposed to be thanking you.
Guess there's no need to worry.
All right. The waterfall is just up ahead.
I guess something like this is right.
I can sense the ancient tongue. We're near one.
Victory shall be mine!
You drop away!
Open the
front gate! Bubble arrow! Open the front gate! Bubble arrow! Break on through!
Blue
flurry! Break down! Break on through! Blue flurry! Blue flurry!
Go!
Experience leads to confidence. Who's next?
Thank you.
ready, Mikleo?
Lord of War!
I'm not a arrow!
Open the floor gate!
Bubble arrow, break on through!
Sweet dreams!
Ocean flip!
Sweet dreams! Well, that was actually pretty decent.
Must have been, if you're complimenting me.
Here to me. Hey, Mikleo, do you think you can freeze this water?
Huh? Yeah, don't see why not.
Then freeze it, and let us bring it back to the sanctuary. Ice is highly resistant to being corrupted by malevolence.
Very well. I'll give it a try.
Thank you very much. That should suffice.
Now, before this melts, we'd better take care of our other problem.
What?
What was that?
The Earth in Zestiria. It finally reacted to something.
So that was something real from the past.
Did you see that, Mikleo? He was writing the celestial record.
Yeah, that must have been the author.
There are more Earth in Zestiria where this came from. If we obtain them, surely we can obtain more information about the past.
Oh man, this is too sweet!
This is only the beginning. Don't get so worked up, or you'll just wear yourself out.
Right.
Whoa, hang on!
He's burning up.
This is a result of the pact we made with Mikleo. He'll get better after some rest at the inn.
I'll carry him back. If we want to cool him down, I guess I better make some more ice.
His fever has gone down.
I'm surprised it only took him one day to recover. It took three when he forged the pact with me.
He's definitely got natural ability as a shepherd.
Mikleo.
Oh, thanks for helping with the letters, by the way. I caught up with everyone I needed to.
It's okay. I rather enjoy writing letters.
Are you awake?
I must have fainted again. Sorry.
You gave me quite a backache.
You looked like you were floating. I told the innkeeper you were just doing some sort of magic trick.
Well, I never was any good at lying anyways.
Don't overexert yourself. You still need to rest.
I'll be fine. We gotta find the Lord of the Land and someone to pray at the sanctuary before the ice melts.
But...
The shepherd has spoken. Is it not the duty of the Prime Lord, Sublord, and Squire to follow him? There you go. Now eat up before it melts.
Oh, a fruit frappe. The arrangement is beautiful.
Just what I'd expect from a water seraph. Something like this would be beyond me.
But Lila, you make sweets too, right?
Well, yes. I'm good at baking, but don't work well with cold things.
Oh, I see. So Lila is good with baking because she's a seraph of fire, and Mikleo is good with cool sweets because he's a seraph of water.
Even seraphim have strong points and weak points.
It's true. I'm really no good at baking.
I'll say, that one time when you tried to cook boar meat, you turned the heat up way too high and burnt it black as coal.
We were both little kids then. And besides, it only happened because you didn't make the fire...
Guys, talking is fine and all, but
if you don't eat, it's going to melt.
Oh, shoot!
Travel can be strenuous at times, but overall, I'm enjoying it.
Oh, right. You spent all those years living in the Sacred Blade. This must be your first time out and about in a long while.
Indeed. And is this your first long journey?
Yeah, for both me and Saray. It's a relief to have companions on the road. I'm looking forward to working with you as the sublord.
My pleasure. Dependable comrades are to be cherished.
I'm glad that you two joined up with us, especially Alicia. Saray's always been a lone human among Seraphim. It's a blessing to have her around.
He seems like he was brought up with a lot of love, regardless of his surroundings.
I won't deny that. But I also have no doubt that there are things only humans can understand, that only humans can see. And he missed out on all of that.
Mikleo.
Please don't tell Saray I said anything.
Of course. It will remain a secret between the Prime and Sublord.
That grilled sweet fish was so delicious, but all they did was just grill it with some salt. Does that even count as cooking?
True enough. All they did was grill it. But that exquisite salt seasoning and tender fish, it brought all the flavor out to the forefront.
The quality of the dish is entirely based on whether or not the flavor was brought out of the ingredients. Therefore, this grilled sweet fish is indeed well prepared.
You're right. I wasn't thinking about it while eating, but this dish has much more depth to it than I thought.
Yes, and the sweet fish is a specialty of the LadyLake region, known for its abundance of clear water. That proves that our ancestors in the Seraphim protected this place. I want to protect this beautiful nature for our future generations.
Do you really think turtles aren't Seraphim?
I'm not sure. As they say, turtles are turtles, though.
They're not turtle hellions, either.
If hellions were like turtles, we'd have it easy.
Then they must be Seraphim.
You can't deny the possibility that they might be human. I mean, they are turtle people, after all.
So if they're Seraphim, then shouldn't they be called Turtlefim?
Well, I don't know about that.
But when you think about it, it's not like humans and Seraphim are all there is in the world.
So then, turtles are turtles. They are what they are.
I'm still not sure, but it'd be neat if that's true.
Definitely. What a rewarding journey this is.
O great Seraphim, whose blessings yet dwell in this land, turn thine ears to our prayers.
Thank you so much, Father Brunor.
No need to thank me. It is your diligent prayer that has made the difference. Be steadfast and pure in mind and spirit as you continue to pray for the health of your son.
A contribution to the sanctuary.
I told you before, madam. I'm afraid I can't possibly...
Please accept it. There's something I've realized. Merely praying for help is an offense to the Seraphim. It is a selfish act for personal gain.
Who told you such a thing?
Well, no one in particular.
You'll need money to pay for your son's treatment, won't you? Use this towards that end instead, for the sake of your son.
My son feels the same as I do. Everyone says the same thing. His wounds were punishment for his selfish prayers. And there are even those who spread vicious rumors about myself and you, Father Brunor. Please, I beg of you, accept this so that we might be saved.
Very well. I shall humbly accept your gift as a token of you and your son's gratitude.
Oh, thank you so much. Now, perhaps these rumors will finally come to an end. May you receive the blessing of the Seraphim, Father.
Right, the blessing. Guess I'll buy a drink. Princess!
I'm here to ask a favor.
Of me? What could I...
We would like to ask you to enshrine and look after a new seraph in our town's sanctuary. This is a request from the shepherd.
The shepherd? You mean this boy is the... Forgive me.
You are not to be blamed. It is the fault of the royal family that so many have strayed from the noble path.
Excuse me, if I may. It's nice to meet you. My name's Saray.
Huh?
I'd like you to be the one to worship at the sanctuary for the protection of LadyLake. I'm sorry for all the trouble I've caused by pulling the sacred blade so carelessly. I know I'm still a fledgling shepherd who hasn't gotten used to things yet, but I promise I will do my best.
Yes, of course. It's quite all right. Please, do not prostrate yourself so.
Thank you.
This request comes from me as well. Please, help me so that I in turn may help this inexperienced but pure of heart shepherd.
Of course. I am honored that I may possibly be of service to one such as yourselves. Though I am frail of body, I shall perform the task at hand with the entirety of my spirit.
I'm glad. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, man. My foot's asleep.
Seriously? Well then, Father Brunor, when you're ready, I will come visit you again.
As you wish. Do be careful.
Well, that's one way to ask a favor, I guess.
It was very Saray.
Yes, I think this helped the priest as well.
Isn't the Sacred Blade Festival also a religious celebration dedicated to the Lady of the Lake? Were you worshipped, Lila?
The Lady of the Lake is a traditional myth of the people of LadyLake, hence the name.
Yes. Who cleanses our sins with the Sacred Blade? Who walks with the mist over the lake? Who vanquishes evil with flames of black? Who sings in the moonlight and comforts the lost souls in the dead of night? The Lady of the Lake, goes the story.
Whoa, Lila! You can walk on water?
Hardly. I weigh at least more than that.
That thing Alicia recited sounded like it might be several myths combined into one.
I would imagine so. The legend was already present when I first arrived in the city.
So wait, does that mean the Lady of the Lake was a different seraph?
Yes, but she was absent, so I accepted the Sacred Blade as my vessel.
So as to wait for the shepherd, right?
As you saw at the ruins in the waterway, LadyLake has a long history of involvement with the Shepherd.
Weren't you lonely all by yourself this whole time?
Not especially. When I got that way, I would distract myself by singing or listening to people's problems.
That's just like the legend.
Huh. I would bet that humans with high resonance were able to sense that.
And blended those tales with the earlier myths to form the current legend. We're seeing history get passed down before our very eyes!